Hey folks, James Jenkins here. Welcome to Propelio Academy. This is the insurance course. This is episode one. There are going to be 13 episodes. Each one of them should last a brief time. We're targeting 3 to 5 minutes. And they are designed so that you can pick and choose what you want out of this course. 13 episodes, each one is topical. They do build on each other. So if you want to start with episode one and just Netflix binge it all the way through, that's totally your prerogative. If you'd rather pick and choose different episodes, you can see from the course listing here on the website which each episode is talking about topic-wise and just pick and choose the ones that are most relevant to you. So, like I said, we are starting from the ground up. I'm assuming that you know almost nothing about insurance, so some of this might be elementary for some of you, and for those of you that are rookie investors and maybe you haven't ever dug deep into an insurance policy before, then this is probably going to be very useful information. So let's just jump right in. Episode one, how to read an insurance policy. We're going to go over the major sections of an insurance policy. Before we get into that, I want to focus on one thing. A lot of people think of insurance as a product that you purchase, a commodity, if you will. The reality is, an insurance policy is, in fact, a legally binding contract. It's called a unilateral contract because the insurance company is the only one that gets to set the terms of the contract. They offer it to you, the policyholder, the consumer, and you choose to either accept it or not accept it. But it's very important that we keep our eyes on the fact that this insurance policy is a legally binding contract. It is not just a product that you choose to purchase. So, major sections of a standard insurance policy. I'm not going to get in the weeds on liability or property or auto or work comp or whatever. This is pretty generic as far as the pieces of a policy. First off, we all know about the deck page if you've ever read anything of an insurance policy. Short for declarations page, and what it really is declaring exactly what the coverage is of the policy succinctly, as shortly as possible. Also, we have what's called the insuring agreement. This is the part of the policy where, if you're smart, you'll read it every word, because the insuring agreement literally tells you exactly what the insurance company is going to provide coverage-wise. And the insuring agreement is the foundation of everything else that comes after it, which includes always exclusions. The insuring agreement says what the coverage is. The exclusions then begin to take away coverage in certain situations. In addition to exclusions, we also have definitions. The policy, anytime there is a word in quotations in an insurance policy, it means that that word is defined in the policy. So if you ever see a word in quotations, you want to read around there and make sure you understand exactly what that definition is. One of the most important definitions is who is an insured. That is very important because if you have insured status on an insurance policy, then you get to enjoy the protections and coverage that it offers. If you are not uninsured, then you don't get to enjoy the protections that it offers. So who is an insured is actually a really important part of the policy. There's also going to be some conditions where the policy may say the coverage applies if blank. And if it doesn't apply, then the condition is not met, and you don't get what it's talking about. And lastly is going to be endorsements. You've got your base policy, whether it's general liability, commercial property, builder's risk, auto, work comp, umbrella, excess, whatever. You've got a base policy. As written, it may not have that much coverage. But endorsements is like bolting on additional coverage to the base to get exactly what you need for your unique situation. So we've got declarations page, aka the deck page, the insuring agreement, the exclusions, the definitions, the conditions, and the endorsements. These are the major parts of an insurance policy. And that's something you need to be very aware of as we go forward with our conversation here today. So, categories of insurance that you should know about. We just went through a bunch of these. General liability, property, which also includes loss rents and loss of use. Excess liability, aka the umbrella policy. commercial auto, which is not just automobiles that are designed to drive down the highway. It can also include self-propelled motorized equipment like the skid steer or the front-end loader. It just depends on the carrier. Sometimes they're considered equipment. Sometimes they're considered an auto. So make sure you're getting it right with your agent. We're going to have that conversation a little bit later. Next is inland marine. It's probably the most awkwardly named category of coverage. Think of this as simply your tools and your small equipment. If it's held by a person, if it's carried around by a person, chances are it's probably inland marine. If it doesn't fit into one of the other categories of property, it's also probably inland marine. And lastly is workers' compensation. This is a bit of a hot topic with investors, especially investors that act as their own contractor, because the question always comes down, am I responsible for providing workers' compensation insurance for the people that are performing labor on my behalf? Oh, I 1099 them. I don't have to provide work comp for them, right? We're going to cover that a little bit later. So just be aware of these major categories of insurance when you're thinking about these things. If you have questions, I'm available for whatever you may have a need for. You can ask the expert if you would like. Just visit this link here. This is my website, jjairm.com/consultation, and you can schedule some time with me later. Obviously, we don't have time to go over everything in these short videos, but feel free to drop me a line and we can chat later. And that's about it for episode 1 of the Insurance Course with Propelio Academy. Thanks for watching.